Hey guys, welcome to the 22nd episode of Q&A. Viewer Subhash has asked in the episode of SDF file from the static timing analysis series, what is pulse rejection limit and E limit? Today, we will be focusing on the definition and example of both the pulse rejection limit and E limit. So sit tight and enjoy the learning experience. Hey folks, welcome back to the computer screen. Today we are answering to viewer's question, what is pulse rejection limit and E limit? This question was asked by Subhash in the episode of SDF and TWF file from the static timing analysis series in episode 9. So let's move on to the next slide. In today's episode, we will be covering the below topics: SDF delay, SDF path pulse, the pulse rejection limit, that is also called R limit. And in the same particular path pulse, we also have the X limit, or which is also called E limit. And we will see the various case studies for the above two. So that's the menu for today. So without any further delay, let's begin. SDF path pulse, pulse rejection limit, also called the R limit. The path pulse entry represents narrow pulse propagation limit associated with a legal path stretched between an input port and an output port of a particular device. These limits determine whether a pulse of certain width can pass through the device and appear at the output. Here is the example. I have shown you this example in the main episode, that is episode 9 in the static timing analysis series. In case you have not seen that particular episode, please go ahead and watch that episode. So here we complete the example, and here is the infographics for the pulse rejection limit. So here in the picture, you can see that two limits have been defined. Now here, if we compare this particular picture with the values, the first value 13 is in time units, is the pulse rejection limit, also known as R limit. This limit defines the narrowest pulse that can appear at the output port of the specified path. Any narrower pulse does not appear at the output. So you can understand from the picture and the example that if pulse width is less than 13, then it is rejected. That is, this is the pulse rejection limit, and we can set it in the SDF file. So I think this is a very clear and present fact. We are done with this particular slide. So let's move on. Now let us look into the X limit or E limit using the same particular example. And here goes our infographics. The second value, 21 in time units, is the X limit, also known as the E limit. This limit defines the minimum pulse width necessary to drive the output of the specified path to a known state. A narrower pulse causes the output to enter into the unknown state or is rejected if smaller than the pulse rejection limit. Note that the X limit, also known as E limit, must be greater than the pulse rejection limit to carry any significance. So here you can see 21 is greater than 13, which is a very much clear and present fact. This kind of numerical difference should be there when these two limits are set. If you specify only one value, both limits are set to that particular value. That means instead of 13 and 21, if we have used only 13, so that particular 13 would be applicable to both the pulse rejection limit as well as the E limit. So that's all the explanation here. Next point, in all cases, value can be either a single number or a triple, but must not be negative. So this word of caution, you must remember in your mind. Now we will look into various case studies. We'll use the same example, and we will use this particular infographics here. In the first pulse, being shorter than 13, it is rejected. The second pulse, being at least 13 but shorter than 21, appears in the output as X. The third pulse, that being at least 21 is passed to the output. You can see that bullets and the infographics are side by side. So this way, this particular limits, that is pulse rejection limit and the E limit. Also, I have given the other aliases to you. These actually defines the transmission of a pulse from an input port to an output port. So here we are done with this particular slide. Let's move on. Thank you very much for watching up to this point. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe. In case you have some dislikes, put that as in words in the comment section down below. And bye for today.